This video is a quick start guide to running a demonstration of sparkling water, which is H2O's integration with Spark. Currently, the demonstration only works on a non-Windows machine, so a Linux or a Mac OS will work fine. And the only other prerequisite is Oracle's Java version 1.7. So if you haven't already done so, please upgrade or install the Java version. First, download the zip file from the link provided. The package will contain a bleeding-edge H2O dev build, which is the upcoming remaster version of H2O, Spark version 1.1.0, a small airlines and prostate dataset, and the scripts to run the demo. To run a simple demo that will start up a master node, 3 worker nodes, as well as 3 H2O JVMs, unzip the file and CD into demo, and subsequently to H2O-example. Execute the run-example script. And you can see if a warning comes up that asks you to set your Spark that underscore local underscore IP variable, it means that you have multiple loopback addresses possible for H2O to start on. And it is best for you to set the variable to the address that H2O will launch on, in which case it will tell you exactly which one your machine determines is the correct address. So kill the job. And then export spark underscore local underscore IP equals to the IP address that H2O has launched on. Then we run the example. And you should see that the warning message no longer appears. Here we're launching 3 H2O instances, waiting for each of the instances to find each other and form a cloud size of 3, with each of the instances having 1 gig, so a cloud size of 3 gigs. It will import and parse the airline's dataset. Do a quick count of the number of flights in H2O as well as through Spark. Then run an SQL query of all the flights coming from San Francisco. Then run a deep learning process in H2O. Run a prediction with the help of the deep learning model that we just created, and exporting out and returning the model predictions. Next, we will try to run a standalone version of Spark and H2O. Kill the Java instance that's currently up and run pkill java to kill any other Java instances that might still be running. Cd to sbin, where you will execute the script launch-spark-cloud, which will launch a Spark cloud. Here we're starting up a Spark cluster with 1 master node and 3 worker nodes. Export the variable master to direct the master node to the Spark IP address. After having started a Spark cluster, go back to your H2O-examples folder and rerun run-example script. So So what you should see happening is the same output you've seen before with the import and parse of the airline dataset. A quick count of the number of flights. And then running deep learning on the subsetted dataset, which is available at localhost 8888. Here you should see the three worker nodes that you started, and the app, which is the H2O integration example, that if you go into, you should see has launched from each of the subsequent worker nodes.